Hi, my name is Alicia Zach. I'm the online learning librarian here at Saddleback College, and I'm going to show you some resources today that can help you with your Environmental 18 science class. So to get to the library, we're going to click on Menu, Student Support, and then we're going to click on Library. Here on the library page, you can see it says find books, articles, and more. I generally use this to find books. And when I say books, I mean books and ebooks. I don't use it to find articles unless I have a specific citation. And if I have that, I might put the title in quotes here and search, but it's not the best at finding articles. To find articles, instead, I would go to our library databases A to Z, or I could click on A to Z Journal Magazines to search for a specific journal or magazine. So let's try that. Okay, so if I wanted to, I could click on Search and Journals, and then I could type in a word that I want to see if we have anything. So let's try ecology. If I hit search now, I can see that we have these results are all journals that have the word ecology in it. I can click on any of them, and it tells me the coverage of when that particular journal spans. So this one is going from 2014 to 2021, and it's available in two databases. So you might see more than two listed here. Here's Ecology and Evolution, and you can see again the date ranges, and sometimes the coverage is different. So in this particular, in ProQuest, they have it from 2011 to present. In Gale Academic OneFile, they have it from 2021 to present. So it's helpful to look at that coverage if there's multiple iterations of it. Once you click on one of the results there, you can see the journal, and you can actually see everything within particular issues. So here we go. I can click on this and I can read it. When I'm reading an article within a database here, I always like to use the full text. The reason being, I can see it as it was originally laid out. I can see the headings really nicely. I can see any of the equations. I can see any of the graphs, charts, and I can also see the page numbers. And that's helpful because I might need to cite something specific, and then I can say exactly what page number it came from. So here we can see this is page 5 of 12. When I find something that I like, I want to save it and I want to cite it. So I can cite it by clicking on the quotes up here, and I can choose a citation style. In ProQuest, they have so many different citation styles. APA and MLA are the two that are used in your class. So you can choose which one you want, click on it, and then you can copy and paste that into your Works Cited. So I said we want to save it and cite it. So to save it, I would click on the three dots here, all options. And then I would click on Google Drive, and that would put this particular article within my Google Drive. I always say save it because you can always delete it from your Google Drive, but sometimes it can be hard to go back and find where you got this from. If you are like me, I end up going down rabbit holes and not sure how I got there. So it can be kind of hard to go back and find the article. I just don't like to do multiple things, same thing multiple times. Okay, so if we wanted to browse topics within environmental science, you can see here we have library databases A to Z. So let's click on that. And this is our homepage here with all of our databases. On the right side, we have our popular databases that are commonly used. On the left side, we have everything listed alphabetically. Up at the top, you can see it says all subjects. I can click on that and scroll down to environmental science. You can see that we have 8 databases specific to environmental science. We have the top three best bets here at the top, and then we have additional databases down here at the bottom. So So let's try one of these out so that we can kind of see how it works. Let's try the environmental studies and policy. Okay, I can put my search term in here. This is the default search bar, or I can click on advanced search. Advanced search just lays out the search for you. So it gives you the Boolean operators and, or not. Usually you're going to be using and. You're going to combine a keyword with another keyword. Sometimes if you have a synonym for something, you might use or because you're open to either word being used. And then not is used to exclude something. So if I was looking for something, let's say from the Amazon rainforest, not the business, I could exclude it by saying not Amazon business or not Bezos. And anything with that word would automatically be excluded. And that just helps tailor your results to what you want. Okay, so let's do an advanced search for seabirds and California. Oops, spelling counts. All right, search. Okay, so this in this database, it defaults to the magazine view. So we can see here magazines 21, academic journal articles 65, and news articles are 18. More often than not, you're going to be using the academic or scholarly peer-reviewed sources here. So if I click on that, I can click here on peer-reviewed and make sure you have the full text also selected. That way, everything that shows up here is actually really available. Sometimes if you don't select full text, all you will see is a abstract, which is enough to get you to know that you want the article, but then it's super frustrating because the full text is nowhere to be seen. So here we can see the article. I can click on download, and if I click on download, I can see the PDF view here. Sometimes the pagination can be surprising in the PDFs because here it's starting with page one, but more often than not, you'll see pagination starting, you know, like page 300 because it's actually referring to a print journal. And then we can cite it by clicking up here and click on the citation style that you're using and copy and paste that into your Works Cited. And let's go back and try another database. So let's try Biological Science Database. This is from ProQuest. And here again, we can see the general search box. I can click on Advanced Search, and again, it just helps lay out the search for me. This time, I'm going to do something different. I'm going to use quotations. I suggest using quotations if you have a phrase that you want to search. So, coastal sage scrub and California. And I'm going to limit to full text, and I'm going to limit to peer reviewed. I could also limit to my publication date, but I want to leave it open right now. All right, so I can see there's 436 results that come up, and that's coming from the publication year 1993 to 2023. If I want to limit it to the last 5 years or so, I can do that over here just by scrolling over to the right, click on update, and now that number went from 430 to 132. And I could continue playing with these limiters over on the left side. I can look at a specific area within California, so Southern California, California, Channel Islands. I can look at subject related to this, and it gives you how many results are associated with that topic or subject. And here I can see the result view. So let's take a look at one of these. And again, it defaults to the web view. I always recommend using the PDF if you can. And here's the abstract, and you can see it's using headings. You've got your introduction and your data, your graphs, the methods, the discussion, and the conclusion. And at the end, you'll see references. So we have a handout here for you guys where we talk about the different types of sources. So we talk about reference materials, our general overview, and it's kind of where you'd want to get started. Books kind of give you a comprehensive background information, and then articles where you'd get specific current data on something. And then we're talking here on the second page, we have scholarly versus popular. So you're asked to use scholarly because of its credibility. Scholarly or peer-reviewed articles go through a rigorous process to get published. They don't have just one editor, but a jury of peers. The language is going to be really specific to your subject. It's written for and by experts in a discipline area. And you should be easily able to identify the credentials of the author. You should be able to see who they are, what do they have a PhD, what institution are they associated with. You should be able to see works cited. If they did a study and it was funded, you should be able to see the funding information versus a popular resource. So think about like a newspaper or National Geographic. There's no peer-reviewed process. It's approved by a paid editor. The language is just kind of for the everyday person to understand. You usually won't see the author's credentials listed, and you most often than not, more often than not, would not see any references listed. You probably would see advertisements, and the language would be written more for mainstream audience, so it's kind of easier to read, and general topics of interest. So this here is kind of going to show you when you're looking at a scholarly article where to look. So if you're looking at the big picture, you want to look at the title first to see is it something that's related to your topic, and then also take a look at the abstract. And then the main points you want to look at in the abstract, in the new claims. So it kind of gives you ideas of where to look. And more information on citations here as well we have for you. Okay. So, in addition to our databases on environmental science and our handout, we have a LibGuide that we've created. And you can access the LibGuide from Canvas under Library Resources, or if you go to the library page, you can access it there as well. Let's go to Student Support, Library, and you can see here we have research guides for lots of classes. Listed alphabetically. Here's Environmental 18. And it kind of goes over what I talked about today. So we talk about what is research. I've got some videos in here. I have a link to our catalog. So you can search in the catalog right there, a video on how that works. I have that information that I talked about, scholarly versus popular. I also talk about using websites. So for your class, you might be using a website to get maybe some statistical information on something. And in that sense, you may want to do an advanced Google search. I'll show you really quickly how to do that. So if you just go straight to Google, and we did California sage scrub, and I hit search, I could then click on the toggle bar up here and click on advanced search, and I could limit by publication date, or I could put a particular domain in. So if I wanted to, I could put in .gov, and maybe I want to put in policy or statistics and see what comes up. And now everything that comes up is going to be a .gov website. And let's see here, when I get to the bottom, you can see it's just coming up with one page of results. So it's a lot less than what we would that what we started with. And so this number up here is everything, but what we have down here is just the .gov results. If you have questions, you can reach out to any of the librarians. You can find us in the library. We're the third floor of the LRC. You can also find us online. On our page here, we have Ask a Librarian. You can click on that and you can chat with us. You can email us. You can visit us in person. If you're stuck, maybe later in the semester when you're working on your paper, You can request a research consultation. We'll ask about your topic. We'll do a little bit of research before you come meet with us, and then we'll show you how we came up with those resources. So you walk away with a list of resources. You can also text us as well. And when you text us or chat with us, you're actually connecting with whoever is at the reference desk. You're not talking with a robot, or anything like that. It's an actual person. So I hope that that is helpful for you. Let me know if you have any questions. My name's Alicia. My email is azak@saddleback.edu.